Hello students, welcome to Narayana Live Classes. Today we discuss 10th class assignment number 35 based on the topic Unit 6 Reading C, A Tale of Three Villages. Right? From that Tale of Three Villages, we read, first question is, read the following passage. Now we have given a passage. Now I think everybody, one of us have read this passage. Let us see the important words here, right? So that we can discuss later, like wistfully, okay? Next one is harvests. Next one is her outstretched arm. Described a complete circle as her outstretched arm, like this, okay? It's like this, right? Stretched arm. And circle we are saying, so that is circle, right? She wants to show the whole circle, the area. Okay, next one is spluttered. Next one is fist. Next one is ominous looking. Right, students? Next is origin. Okay, origin. Next one is shroud. And now next one is manifold. Okay, these are the important words. Now one more thing I just wanted to tell you. Then they. Now who they? They are the factory owners who built the factories. Okay, built those. Now those monsters. Monsters. Those monsters. Right? Monsters are. Monsters. What do you mean by monsters actually? Monsters is, you know, his giant colossus. All this. Okay. But here, factories are the monsters, okay? Now, those means factories, okay? They means the factory owners, and those means the monsters, factories belong, okay? So, let us see some important points of this passage. Now, this village become a victim of industrialization, okay? This village became a victim of industrialization. The second point, factories were set up to make leather goods. Now the factories were set up to make leather goods, right? The third point is, these factories release many poisonous chemicals. Okay, the third point is, these factories release many poisonous chemicals. Right, students? Next. Now the villagers are facing severe problems due to pollution. Now, who are facing problems? Villagers. The villagers are facing severe problems due to pollution. The last point, they have to walk 10 kilometers. Who have to walk? They means villagers. They means villagers. Okay, villagers have to walk 10 kilometers daily to get drinking water. Okay, so these are the important points. Next is, I told you, I just underlined few words in the beginning of the class. The first one is wistfully. Wistfully used as an adverb, okay, which means sadly, right? Next, harvest. Harvest is a noun which means crops. Okay, next, outstretched. Stretched out full length hand. Okay, stretched out. So this is outstretched. Now splutter. Splutter is used here as a verb. Now here splutter means to speak quickly and with difficulty because you are angry. Right? Next, fist. Fist is something like this. Okay? We all know what is fist. Fist is a noun. A hand when it is tightly closed with the fingers bent into the palm. So this is the fist. Right? Next. Ominous looking. Ominous looking, suggesting that something bad is going to happen. Something bad is going to happen is ominous looking. Origin. Origin is a noun. The line at which this earth, surface and sky appear to meet. Okay. They don't meet, but you look. You know, they resembles like that. They are meeting, right? At one point. So next is shroud. Shroud is a noun. Something that hides or covers something, right? Next, men folk is a noun, the men in a family, right? So this is the important points and meanings. Now we will get into our assignment. Answer the following questions. We have given 5 questions. Each question carries 2 marks. Write them up. Next, how was the Ponimanthuri village before this? How was the village? Because we have mentioned harvest, means crops, it's green, right? So see here, all the fields around the village were green and the harvests were good. So this is the first question, right? Now second question. What do you think the women of the village have to walk 10 kilometers every day? Why do you think the women of the village have to walk 10 kilometers every day? The women of the village have to walk 10 kilometers every day in order to bring water, because the industries, okay, the industries disposed their chemicals into the water flowing through the village. Right, students? So this is the answer. Next one. Why does Vijay Sama say we don't buy leather shoes or leather handbags or leather clothes? Why? Vijay Sama says we don't buy leather shoes or leather handbags or leather clothes because their families, lives and health have been destroyed because of these factories. Right, students? This is the third question. The next question is, when they built those monsters, what are those monsters? The monsters are the buildings of the leather industry, or you can say factory also, right? Next, who gave assurance to the villagers? Who gave the leather factory management gave assurance to the village? What assurance? That all men will get jobs, right? So this was the assurance was given by the village, the factory owners. So that's all for today's assignment. Meet you in the next session. Till then, good luck, goodbye.